slideshow from today. Okay. Today we're gonna start with equilibrium, supply demand model and harvest model. Okay. Equilibrium of a dynamical system generated by an autonomous system of ordinary differential equation is a solution that does not change with time. Okay. Geometrically, the equilibria are points in the system space. And equilibria are sometimes called the fixed point or steady states. Okay. We often refer equilibria as time-independent solution of the ordinary differential equations. Okay. As the time-independent solution of iterated map of t plus 1 is equal to f of x of t. Here, in this economic system, the price don't move anywhere at the equilibrium point. After it moves around, then at the equilibrium point, it settles down. It stays there. So, okay, like a fixed point or steady state. We see that motion is pendulum of those two types. And one is in the very stable situation, but the one, even if we learning the pendulums, it can stand up at the top, which is but still this is this can be easily broken the stability. So this situation can be called unstable, and this motion is pendulum position. Is called the stable, can be called the stable condition. Okay. Here's a simple example of equilibrium in supply-demand model. Supply-demand is an economic model based on price, utility, price or utility and quantity in a market. It concludes that in a competitive market, price will function to equalize the quantity demanded by consumers, resulting in an economic equilibrium of price and quantity. Yes, as the price go up, the demand will be decreased, and if you lower the price, then demand will increase. It's like this. So price P of a product is determined by a balance between each price, supply, and the desire of those with purchasing power. It's called the demand, along with the consequent increase in price and the quantity sold of market. So here supply S and demand D, price P, and quantity sold as Q will be the notation that we're gonna, which was used in the graph and which will be used later. Here is the next question is how we can find the equilibrium points from the supply demand model. And this is the user formula for demand. So if the prices go up, then demand will be decreased. If prices go up, then supply, the supplier will be willing to make a lot more as price goes up. So with these are the typical one model of supply demand model. And then we can form the Excel model with a simulator to produce the data to play with. So the effect of on price and quantity can be shown like this. Here the question mark means indeterminate, and the supply and demand changes. This shows. So if the prices go up, then then supply will increase, but the demand will be decreased. And if we reduce the price, then the production will be decreased, but the quantity sold will be increased. So it will change, it will move in this pattern. This is a demand curve. This is a supply curve. So on this, the price will give effect on those changes as we mentioned. So as we see here, we will see a kind of curve in this supply demand model. So here is the Excel file that we made and uploaded in iCampus. So may some of you already have practiced on it. And Mr. Huang translated this file to the English version, so all can play with it now. And as you see, this formula was saved as a demand, and this formula was formulated in the supply. And then, as you see, the changes here, and this shows the cobweb graph in the plane. Okay, like you see. So how we can find the equilibrium point from here? As you see, if you draw the graph of these data, which was produced from the given demand and supply conditions, then as you see, it's been moved like this, and it will end up at a certain point, which is an equilibrium. So if you can draw the data and simulations, and then you can easily find the point that converges, that can be called the curve point, a curve web point, and also that is going to be the candidate for the equilibrium point. Okay. Here, we may face some case that we don't see the graph does not converge to a stable point. Then in this case, first the supply was determined by its price and demand in the market, and we must consider its effect in the real market. So we have to reformulate the formulas and equations to fit the real market situations. Okay. One other example is a harvest model. In logistic gross model, if we add the harvesting process on the gross on it, then it will give us the harvest model. In this model, we consider supply and the possible harvest goods, and then real harvest, and then we will have the profit such as the profit of the farm and or other data that can be shown in the table. And also we have to consider the growth rate and the capacity in this harvest model. So first thing that we have to consider is the changes in supply. Okay, like you see DSDT, that in the harvest model, this is the common equation which can be drawn from the data. The alpha times 1 minus theta S minus H. Here, theta is the supply over the capacity. And here, this, and this alpha is the growth rate, and and this H is the harvest. So with those given information, we can form changes in supply as we can easily find. With these data, that we can form the Excel file with those formulas for the growth rate, the changes in supply, and the harvest, and then the remainings here. So if we give initial conditions like this, then automatically it will generate the data like this, and then that can draw the graph of it. So you can easily practice this model. So this model can be used most of the harvest model case. Okay, here. Okay, what then next question is, what is the equilibrium point in harvest model and how we can find it? Here, equilibrium point is one to make a balance between the growth and the harvest of the object. And using the cobweb, we can find the equilibrium point as well. Here, as you see, we can identify the functions like this from the one we had. This formula can be formed from the growth with the growth rate and capacity and harvest, like you see. And with those data, you will see the graph like this. Here you also see the cobweb like this. From here we can deduce the point of the equilibrium from this graph. Okay, so this. These are the basic the formulas for the harvest model. Mm-hmm. And next things are physical models, and such as projectile and planet orbits that we're gonna continue. Okay, before we continue, is there any question? Okay. Then we may go back. Let's continue to go to the iCampus so we can simulate some of the situations that we have mentioned, and also we will discuss what you have practiced. Any questions?